Brooks, the Boss Man winner, and I'm the Community Energy Associate here at the Island Institute.
And I'm Andrew Doerr, the Economic Development Associate here at the Island Institute.
Today, we're going to show you how to build these simple, low-cost, energy-saving interior storm window inserts for your home. So, let's start with the materials you'll need. You want a tape measure, or a digital laser tape measure, my favorite tool. You want a chop saw, or a handsaw, a drill, a hairdryer. You're gonna want wood, so we use 1x4-inch wood, ripped in half.
Sorry about that.
And cut to length. Screws. We use 3-inch drywall screws. Double-sided tape, foam weather stripping, packing tape, shrink wrap, plastic film.
Got the scissors?
And scissors or an X-Acto knife, something like that. So, those are the materials you'll need.
Great. Well, looks like we have all these things. Let's get to building. While we're here, though, we have a few people helping us build these windows today. With us are the Island Fellows. Should we welcome the Fellows, Brooks?
Hello, Fellows!
Now let's get building. Detailed instructions are available on our website. Measure and cut your wood to length. When measuring the cross pieces, make sure you account for the width of the length pieces and the foam weather stripping. Refer to your cut sheet for more information. Then screw together the frames, placing one screw in each corner with the length pieces outside of the cross pieces. After you have your frame screwed together, you will want to stick double-sided tape along the outside edges of the frame. This will allow you to stick the shrink film we will apply next. With the double-sided tape, roll around the outside of the frame. Then roll out the desired length of film. Be sure to leave about 4 inches on either end so that you have enough to wrap around the edge and cut from the larger roll. Lay the frame down on the open piece of film. Remove the covering from the double-sided tape and fold the film over the sides of the frame. Remove any excess film with scissors or a knife. Once you've applied one layer of shrink film, flip your window over and repeat these steps to make a second layer of film on the other side of the frame. Now that you have your film on the frame, you will likely notice some wrinkles. No one wants to look through a wrinkly window, so we're going to shrink the film and create a tight, clear, and transparent surface. Using a hairdryer, turn on the highest and hottest setting. Start with a corner and work your way across the window slowly, being sure the hairdryer is about 3 inches from the film. You can burn through the film if you hold the hairdryer too close for too long. Run packing tape along all of the edges of the frame, ensuring that the film will hold tightly over time. Next, make 2 tabs with the packing tape and place them on opposing sides of the frame so that you have something to pull when removing the windows next spring. Finally, you will need to apply the foam weather stripping. Apply the foam to each side and leave about 1/2 inch to 1 inch excess in the corners. This will allow for a tighter fit as many of our older main homes have shifted and moved ever so slightly.
Great, let's go see if this thing fits. For you religious folks out there, say a prayer.
For everyone else, grab a hammer.
Brooks, wait, no. No, finesse, Brooks. We can fit it in with our hands.
All right. And there you have it, folks. It fits.
Thanks, everyone, for joining us today. For more detailed instructions and a cut sheet, please look online at our website.
And stay warm out there.